In the mighty name of Jesus. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
One of the strong arguments you will hear people around the world, those of us who have been on evangelical field in different continents of the world, one strong argument is that God is no more what he used to be in those days, in the days of the Bible particularly. People tell you, oh, we read all these things in the Bible, but how come they're not, it's like they're not happening today? Is he the same God? Yes, he's the same God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, the answer is that he's the same God. But let me tell you, he is what you believe him to be for you personally.
Amen.
God, he is. God will be to you what you believe him to be. If he's powerful, you will see him powerful.
Amen.
If he's great, you will see him great. Your personal faith. So it depends on the personal approach, how you approach God. How much of your heart, how much of your commitment, how much of your faith that you exercise towards God. Based on that, God will reveal himself to you.
Amen.
Yes, the owner of the universe in days of Abraham, days of Noah, we read of Red Sea, a sea divided. The people passed through dry land, read of the flood, and where Noah and his family alone were saved. Read of Joshua stopping the sun and the moon in order to prevail over an enemy.
Wow.
Read of the lepers. So many things in the Bible. Yes, he's still the same.
Amen.
But the question is, how did they approach him in those days? What kind of relationship? What kind of relationship? Was it an intimate one? Was it distant relationship? Cordial, casual, and intimacy. Three types of relationship. Is that it's cordial, or casual, or intimate? And so, it depends. God will reveal himself to you the way you approach him personally. If you give him half of your time, you will see him half of your time. If you give him all your heart, he will take all of you. But if he said, he's a God that I approach when I have time, so will he be to you. Those people we read in the Bible who God revealed himself to them in a powerful way, they gave themselves in a very powerful way to God.
Amen.
In a singleness of heart, they gave themselves to God. And God still do the same today.
Amen.
Based on your personal relationship with God. Because Christianity is about relationship. Your relationship with God draws you to him and ushers you to his glory, where you will receive from God. That is why you should not judge anybody. You should not judge anyone. You should just preach the truth. Encourage people to serve God. Because you don't know the man you are talking about. Maybe his own faith is bigger than yours. I want to take us to the scripture immediately. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 13. Hebrews chapter 13. I'm going to begin to read. I want to speak to us today on the topic I say, the God of old is still the God of now.
Hallelujah.
The God of old is still the God of now.
Amen.
The God of old is still the God of now. The God who appeared to Moses in a burning bush, that God is the same.
Amen.
The God who sent the manna from above to his children, that God is still the same. He's still more powerful, even more than the those of old. He's still a powerful God.
Hallelujah.
There's no question about it. But you cannot deceive God. You cannot deceive God. We can be 1,000 of us in this house worshiping God. God reveals himself to us individually. Oh my God. If you are consumed with the love of God, the same way you see God, like David of old, who was totally sold out to God. These days, men don't want to be sold out to God. We are too intelligent to serve God. We are too economical when it comes to our time to serve God. And that is the way God, you will see God. Because that is where you are. That is your level. The level of your faith is where you are. And that's the only way you can see God. The way I see God now is different from the way you see God. It's based on how many percent of myself I've given to God. And so the question is it the same God? Yes, it's the same God. But those men encountered God. They encountered God because they gave God their all.
Amen.
They did not serve God with tricks. They did not serve God with deception. They did not serve God with mocking and murmuring, fighting, dividing. No. They gave all to God.
Hallelujah.
If you want to see God, no matter how old you are, you can still see God.
Amen.
If you make a decision today and say, if this God is real, I want to see him. Let me give him myself. Let me give him my heart. Let me give him my time. You will see him.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
The God of the old is the God of today.
Amen.
That's what God wants to do. The same. Okay, let's read Hebrews starting from verse 8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever, be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines, for it is a good thing that the heart of man be established. The heart of man be established with grace. Can you say, my heart be established with grace?
My heart be established with
not
grace.
Not with meat, which have not profited them that have been occupied in their realm. Let your heart be established in Jesus, in God.
Amen.
Let your heart be established in Jehovah.
Amen.
Some people once came to Jesus. They were listening to Jesus as he was preaching, his way of preaching. And time was going, and it was becoming night. And the disciples said, Lord, let these people go. Let them go. He said, no, they should not go. Give them something to eat. And then some pieces of bread and fish were brought, and Jesus prayed and multiplied it, and they ate and rejoiced and danced. I said, whoa, glory to God. The next day, they were looking for Jesus. Because already their hearts were established in the bread. They were looking for Jesus. People go about looking for miracle. Hey, prophet, that prophet. Do you know they're not looking for God? They are looking for the miracle he performs.
That's right.
It's not everyone you see in the church that is looking for God. Some are looking for God who will buy them new house, new car, good wife. Once they get that thing, okay, God, go your way. The heart of such man is not yet established in God. And so, listen to me. The next day they came to Jesus and said, and they told Jesus, these men are looking for you. He said to them, no, you are not looking for me, you are looking for bread.
That's right.
You are not looking for me, you are looking for bread. You are looking for miracle. You are looking for signs and wonders. You don't love me. You don't have a relationship with me. I can't see you in my presence.
Lord have mercy.
When people lift up their hand in the church, I see some hand, but I don't see your hand. You are far away. You just want your belly to be filled. That's the kind of people who see serving God these days. Don't be deceived. When you see them as somebody who wants to serve God, you say, you get discouraged. Say, this one serve God. No. They are far away from God. Their action will show you that they are far away from God. Their decisions will tell you that they are far away from God. Their behaviors will show you that they are far away from God. For about 2 years now, by the grace of God, we have this permission to go and pick up food everywhere. Pick food everywhere and be distributing food for hungry people. I will get this food plenty every week. And I will drive and drive and drive looking, trying to give food here and there, trying to give food here and there. And I just came in contact with a man. When I came in contact with this man, it was about something else. But I was told that he was a good man. When he came to the church here, to my office, and realized what we do, he said, wow, this is good, this is wonderful. Do you know that man took upon him to be taking those food to go and give to hungry people?
Hallelujah.
Tell me if God bless the man tomorrow. You will tell me that you're a pastor. Why shouldn't God bless you first? Sorry, you're a pastor. Just your title. You don't do the work. Sorry, you're a Christian. Just Christians. You don't care. So many Christians don't care. Their heart is so wicked. They don't have love in their hearts. They don't care. That's why they destroy a lot. The same way, this is a warning to myself. Oh, glory to God. I feel like shouting. If you want to see God, give yourself the way you will see God.
Hallelujah.
Let the heart of a man be established in the Lord.
Amen.
If your heart is established in the truth, if your heart is established in a sound judgment, if your heart is established in decency, if your heart is established in love, you will not fail.
Amen.
I say you will not fail.
Amen.
You will have victory in every battle.
Amen.
Because God will back you.
Amen.
God backs a man that his heart has been given to God. We are millions lifting our hands every Sunday. But there are few of us that God sees and notice that they are there.
Hallelujah.
The God of old is a God of now.
Amen.
People are very fond in thinking about God as a past tense. They say, oh, it's a thing of past. Oh, God did wonders. He performed miracles, it's a thing of past. No. Jesus, the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen.
The God of the mountain is the God of the valley.
Hallelujah.
Hey, the God that created heaven and earth, he's still in charge.
Amen.
Do you know people in the Jews in Jesus' days? The Jews in Jesus' days, they had the same issue. When they saw Jesus as a little boy, the carpenter's son, they said, they saw him speaking big things, speaking wisdom, intelligently, and they said, what? Which university did he this? Has he been taught at all? But look at what he told them. If you go to John chapter 8, John chapter 8, they had an argument with Jesus. Because they were living in rebelliousness. They were very rebellious. That's what people have. When people are very unbelief and rebellious, they always argue with God. Get this now. Get this now. People that are very rebellious always argue with God. They always fight with God. But the sheep of the Lord, they follow their master.
Amen.
When they hear the voice of their master, they follow him. Jesus said, I know my sheep and they know me. When they hear my voice, they will follow.
Amen.
But those who are not the sheep will be very argumentative. They will be very challenging. In fact, they wish to rewrite the scripture. They wish to cancel some verses in the scripture.
Lord have mercy.
And so these men, Jewish men, children of Abraham, had an argument with Jesus. In John chapter 8, I'm going to read from verse 56. John 8 from 56. It says, your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it and was glad. He was saying something strange. A young man talking about Abraham, seeing him. Then said the Jews unto him, thou art not yet 50 years old. Hast thou seen Abraham? Serious argument. Have you seen Abraham? How can you, a young man, you're not up to 50 years old, you're talking about Abraham. That is a carnal mind question. Amen?
Amen.
Verse 58. Jesus said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham
was
I am. They say, what? What are you talking about? Before Abraham you were? He was simply telling them that the God of Abraham is his God.
Amen.
And that he is in fact the representative of the God of Abraham.
On earth.
On earth. But because they were spiritually blind, they say, hey, look at what they decided. They said, okay, now you are in trouble. Look at verse 59. Then they took them up stones to cast at him. But Jesus himself and went out of the temple, going through the midst of them, and so passed by. When you speak mystery, spiritual mystery to blind people spiritually, they mock. They don't understand. When people come to ministries or serving God anywhere they are serving God, when you begin to encourage them the way to follow God, they think it's so selfish. This God, this your God wants all my time. This your God self is demanding a lot. They don't know that if you follow God, you see God.
Amen.
I said if you follow God, you see God.
Hallelujah.
If you follow your senses, like these Jewish men, Jesus, their Messiah, was there with them. The Messiah they prayed, they boasted about, was there with them. But they couldn't recognize him. That's what happens in the blind spiritual person. He will not recognize things. You can be showing him the right thing. He will not see. Because spiritually they are blind. Because the things of God are spiritually designed. And they sound foolish to a natural man.
That's right.
The things of God sound foolish to a natural man. You can't use your senses to serve God. You will use your heart to serve God.
Amen.
It's a dedicated heart that will serve God.
Amen.
Not human sense.
Amen.
You can't find God in your computer. You can't Google God. It's not possible. You can Google anything. You can't Google God.
Hallelujah.
The God of the old is the God of now.
Amen.
If you want to see him, approach him the right way.
Amen.
You will see him.
Amen.
If you see him as a great God, he became great to you.
Amen.
If you see him as a God of half time, he gives you half time.
Mm.
If you see him as a God that you can abuse, he'll give you abuse. If you see him as God that can do wonders and do everything, he will do it for you.
Amen.
And so the God of the old is the God of today.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is someone listening to me?
Yes, sir.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Oh, glory. What a great God we serve.
Amen.
I want to show you something. If you go to the book of Samuel, 1 Samuel, the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 2, 1 Samuel chapter 2, get it for me, please. 1 Samuel chapter 2, okay, I've seen it. 1 Samuel chapter 2, is that what I want to read first? Yes. 1 Samuel chapter 2 from 7. Can you just play it for me? From 7. Thank you. Now, you have to understand that God is the one that gives victory.
Amen.
We don't get victory by our own power. I'm going to make a very serious statement now. I'm looking for a way to bring it out. We serve God, actually. We are called to love God, actually. But when it comes to victory, God is the one that gives you victory.
Amen.
Because sometimes we think, because I have been in the Lord for 50 years, I can just have victory anyhow. God gives that victory. That is why you don't have to disconnect from him. Do you want to have victory in what you are doing now? You must keep on being connected.
Amen.
Being associated.
Amen.
Worshiping.
Amen.
God in spirit and truth.
Amen.
Because he's the one that gives victory.
Amen.
This was the experience of Hannah. Hannah, the barren woman. He said, the Lord maketh Paul. When she was praising God after she got she conceived Samuel, she began to praise God.
Hallelujah.
They tell the Lord make it poor and make it rich to inform men. God, do you want to be rich? God makes rich.
Hallelujah.
And God can also make people poor.
Hmm.
Oh my God, sorry. If God makes you are poor indeed. God have mercy.
God have mercy.
I reject that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So God can make people poor. Mm. That means you go to market, he will make sure you carry your bread, go back home. Mm. That means you have PhD. Your PhD will be like 11.36.
Mm.
You begin to clean toilet somewhere.
Lord have mercy.
God will not make you poor in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said, he bringeth low and lifted up. He raised up the poor out of the dust. And lift up the beggar from the dunghill. Go up for me, please.
Hallelujah.
Go up for me. God, to set them among princes and to make them inherit the throne of glory.
Hallelujah.
I'm still reading. For the pillar of the earth. Oh, yeah. So the earth has got pillar. Like this house. Where is the pillar? Can I see the pillar? Oh, glory. The earth has got pillar. Who? Let me ask you a question, man. Do you know the pillar of the earth? Have you seen one before?
No.
The earth of God pillar. Yeah. What a God.
Hmm.
For the pillar of the earth are the Lord's. He has set the world upon them.
Hmm.
Maybe this is where they got this idea of pillar, the builders.
Hmm.
He will keep the feet. Go up. Verse 9. He will keep the feet of his saints.
Hallelujah.
God keeps me. Can you say God keeps me?
God keeps me.
He will keep the feet of his saints, and the wicked shall be silent in darkness.
Amen.
Now look at the first one, the last one, the last phrase I want to read, where I'm coming. For by strength shall no man prevail.
Amen.
Oh, people want to prevail by strength.
Hmm.
They want to prevail by, I came from a great family. My father used to be bishop. No, that is not the yastic. My Bible is bigger than everybody's Bible. I went to theology somewhere. No. It's the way you submit to him.
Amen.
There's no way you go about feeling the hungry, looking after the widow, looking after the poor, encouraging people.
Mm.
And then God will leave you, will not bless you. God bless a man that is too big for him.
Mm.
Somebody who cannot bend down and serve God.
Mm.
Somebody who cannot be humble. Somebody who cannot take instruction. Do you want God to bless you?
Yes, sir.
Do something to provoke God's blessing.
Amen.
Hey, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
You provoke God to bless you.
Amen.
By your action.
Amen.
By your services.
Mm.
You provoke God to bless you.
Amen.
God doesn't bless anyhow. He will not waste his blessing.
Amen.
I'm telling you the truth. He will not waste his blessings.
Thank you, Jesus.
No one has been blessed by God, has been blessed at all, without God's hand upon him.
Amen.
But mind you, what you call blessing in the world is not what
God
the Bible considers blessing.
That's right.
The Bible considers a blessed man as somebody who has good relationship with God.
Amen.
I know we consider blessed man as somebody who has got big houses.
Hmm.
You can get big houses, of course, if you're serving God very well. You can have all the riches in this world, but the thing that makes you a rich person is your relationship with God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
That's God's definition of rich.
Mm.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
And so those people that gave themselves to God, look at this. Those people that gave themselves, gave their life, gave their time, gave their commitment to God, God fight for them. God gives them blessing without sweat.
Amen.
God gives them go ahead without interruption.
Amen.
God gives them open door without any man closing it.
Amen.
Because they have given their heart, their time, their everything to God.
Amen.
You can be looking down on them, but I promise you God is with them.
Mm. Hallelujah.
You can be looking down on them, judging them, but I promise you God is with them.
Amen.
God will fight for them.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
God will fight for them.
Amen.
Ah, I know what I'm talking about. Please take us to Psalm, the book of Psalm 44. The people of old crying about something, Psalm 44. The book of Psalm 44, we're going to read, I believe, from verse 1. Yes. Psalm 44 from verse 1. We have heard with our ears. This is people of God now talking. We have heard with our ears. Oh God, our fathers have told us what God that did in their days, in the times of old. Oh, we had a testimony from Abraham, a testimony from Moses, the prophets of old. Even the Bible spoke about them. The great things God did in the days of old. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The great things God did in the days of old. The Bible said, how thou didst drive out the heathen. God himself drove out the heathen. Mm. What the people did was that they served him, they worshiped him, then he took upon them, upon himself, to drive away their enemies, to drive away their enemies.
Amen.
How thou didst drive out the heathen with thy hand and plantest them. How thou did afflict the people and cast them out. Mm. Look at verse 3. For they got not the land in possession or the blessing in possession by their own sword, neither did their own arm save them, but thy right hand and thy arm. Why? And the light of thy countenance, because thou hast favor unto them.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because God favored them, he had favor on them. How can you attract God's favor and remain poor?
Hmm.
How can you attract God's favor and remain poor? Have you seen a man that is favored by God?
Hmm.
Their life is like magic.
Hmm.
Some years ago, I met a child of God in this country. And he came, he was a minister back home. He came, he was ministering with me. I was, you know me now, I like to welcome pastors. I like to give chance to those who want to serve God. That's the way I preach. Because the pulpit is not mine. I can only preach in part. I don't want to die on pulpit. When I preach, some people also preach. Praise God. Some people want to stay in the pulpit because it belongs to them. And so I was encouraging him. He was a lawyer. And we're praying. He started making some visa application, indefinite leave to remain. Before you know it, he was not here up to 4 years. He was given surprisingly indefinite leave to remain in this country.
Hallelujah.
Somebody who came in as a visitor. You ask me, hey, do you know by law, when you visit this country, you can't change your visa status.
Mm.
Can only go back home and be change it. You can't change your visa status in this country as a visitor. The highest you can do is that your visa will be extended maybe 1 month, maybe 2 months. But this guy, because he was consumed, I loved him because he was consumed with God. Everything about him is about God. Though he was an intelligent man, a lawyer indeed. Before 4 years, he secured indefinite leave to remain. This is just one of the testimonies. When a man is favored by God, you will not understand him.
That's right.
A man, the way he is blessed, the way God blesses him,
mm-hmm.
When a woman is favored by God, the way God will work in their lives.
Amen.
So the best thing you will do in your life is to get God's favor on your side.
Hallelujah.
How do you do that? Do things that provokes the blessings of God.
Amen.
Do things. Don't follow somebody else. Listen to me. I know there are a lot of facts. I know there's a lot of things, false things. But I also know that God is real.
Amen.
Because some people say, oh, I don't want to serve God again because that pastor, that prophet, that elder, that sister, that brother. Okay, you know that they are bad. But do you still know that God is real?
Mm.
Mommy, do you still know that God is real? Or you're just using that as an excuse that you don't want to serve God again?
Mm.
How come you want to change your approach to God by somebody's behavior?
Lord have mercy.
How come you don't want to serve again? So serve God again because of somebody behaved funny.
Mm.
Oh, that means you don't love that God at all. That means you don't love that God at all. You just claim you love God. You don't love God. That is why when you see any kind of behavior that is wrong, you change your love for God. You disconnect from God. You stop doing what you are doing before. You say, I will not go for evangelism. Evangelism again. I'm not going to serve again. I'm not going to do that again. That means you don't love God. Those that God has favored, they live above the law.
Hallelujah.
They defy protocol. Protocol. They don't know what is due process.
Mm.
God jumps processes for them. This God is still the same today.
Amen.
This is what I want to communicate to you. This God is still the same God today. The God of all. The God who did it for Hannah can do it for you.
Amen.
The God who did it for David can do it for you.
Amen.
Go close to him. Open your heart to him. Open your heart to him. Serve him. Not with tricks. Not with trouble. They say, our fathers told us what you did in the days of old. They got not the land by their power, by their minds. But you drove away their enemies and put them in the land because you had favor on them.
Mm.
May the Lord favor you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I declare upon your life the favor of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the favor of God baptize you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the favor of God baptize you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
What am I talking about? This God is faithful.
Amen.
This God is wonderful.
Amen.
It doesn't matter when you started.
That's right.
And brother, listen to me. It doesn't matter when you started. What matters is where you are.
That's right.
It doesn't matter when you started. You may be just starting now. But because God is with you, it will look like you began before everyone. God can change things today.
That's right. Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to God.
Instantly.
God can change things today.
Amen.
Based on your approach.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Let's go to Romans chapter 8. I'm going to be done very soon with two places I will read. Romans chapter 8, the book of Romans. No. Romans chapter 15. Sorry about that. Am I right? No, Romans chapter 9 from 15. Romans chapter 9 from 15. For he said to Moses, you know, Moses was a man that related with God wonderfully. He worshipped God wonderfully. Moses was consumed by him. Everything about God was in Moses. He said, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. God said, when it comes to mercy, I am entitled to give mercy to someone I wish to do so. And I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. What this means is that go to God, not to men, to get mercy. Go to God, not to men, to get compassion.
Hallelujah.
Verse 16. Look at this. Paul summoned it in this way. 16. So then, it is not of him that willeth, not of him that runneth, but of God that shows mercy.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Serve God, don't serve men. Focus to God, not man.
Hallelujah.
If you can't get it from God, you cannot get it from man. Oh, that you said you entered that office, things changed. It's because God has given it to you already.
Amen. Favor. Hallelujah.
You said you got that job after the interview, they just took you. Because God has given it to you already.
Amen. Favor.
So what you have to do is to go and get it from God.
Amen.
If you get it from God, the witches, we have no choice but to release it.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
All your things that witches are holding, I command them to release it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
If Hallelujah. You get it from God, the home office will bow.
Amen.
The law will give thanks.
In the name of Jesus.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Because God was with Israel. When Israel approached Red Sea, the Red Sea say, who are these guys?
Hallelujah.
They say, these guys are guys, they are Jesus people.
Amen.
The Red Sea, okay, let's give chance now. Let's Amen. Give them chance.
Amen. Amen.
The Red Sea in its accord, the Red Sea in its own accord, divided.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, glory.
Hallelujah.
And they passed through dry land. And the unbelievers wanted to try.
And they drowned.
They let man try. What kind of miracle is this? They went in the Red Sea and said, I don't know you. Who are you? When they entered, the sea swallowed them.
That's right.
When God is with a man, he's a dangerous man.
Amen.
When God is with a woman, don't look down on her.
Amen.
When God is with people, don't look down on them.
Amen.
God is wonderful.
Hallelujah.
The God of all.
Is the God of
now.
Amen.
This is the message he wants me to give you today.
Amen.
So that your faith will grow.
Amen.
Beyond all those barriers.
Hallelujah.
Because the God, what he did in the days of old, he can do for you.
Amen.
Thank he you. Healed, he still healed today.
Amen.
He performed miracle, he still performed miracle today.
Amen.
But you know the key? The key is your relationship with him.
Hallelujah.
The key is how much of yourself you've given to him.
Amen.
The key is how much of your family you've given to him.
Amen.
The key is how much of your heart is with God.
Hallelujah.
If your heart is divided, if it's only 1%, that is how you will see God. If it's only 2% of your heart, that's how you see God. If you give God 100% of your heart, God will come in 100% and decree God's 100% upon you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. My people, I'm going to pray very soon.
Hallelujah.
I'm so much excited. I don't want to keep you here forever. I just want to remind you, Labasa Katamuria.
Thank you, Lord.
I just want to remind you of the God of those days. He's still the God of today.
Amen.
Don't mind the people that argue a lot. The God of those days is still the God of today. He's still the God of now. He's still wonderful. He's still doing wonders. You better get that. Okay. Zechariah chapter 4, finally. Zechariah chapter 4. Zechariah chapter 4. I want to release the power of God upon your life. I'm going to read from verse 6. Zechariah chapter 4 from verse 6. The release of God is your portion this day.
Amen.
You will go and conquer territories.
Amen.
Everything, that need, that being, that need, that thing you have been desiring from God, receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That door that closed for a long time, let that door open in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let that door open in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Zechariah chapter 4, reading from verse 6 says, then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's not by power. When God speaks, just believe him that he is able to do it.
Amen.
It's not by your might or by your power, but by his own power and by his own mind.
Amen.
And he said, who are you? Who art thou, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Thou shalt become a plain.
Amen.
He shall bring forth the headstone thereof. We're shouting what?
Grace.
Because you're a man of grace, you will see grace.
Amen.
The grace of God is upon you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moreover, the word that the Lord said unto me, saying,
not by might.
The hands of Sally have started this. The hand of Moses have started this.
Amen.
The hands of Zerubbabel have laid the foundation of this house.
Hallelujah.
His hand also shall
complete it.
He also shall finish it.
Amen.
And thou shalt know that the Lord of hosts has sent me unto you.
Amen.
The word of the Lord to you for you today is this. If you give more of yourself to God, if you dedicate more of yourself to Him, if you give Him totality of your heart, if you get consumed of God, or consumed by God, His love, His worship, you stop using your head to calculate the things of God, and start using your heart to follow God, to serve God, you will begin to see wonders of God.
Amen.
You will begin to see wonders of God.
Amen.
Oh, I have my testimonies. It's time with fellows here. You begin to see wonders of God. Impossibility will become possible.
Amen.
God will begin to favor you everywhere. God will open your brain.
Hallelujah.
God will use you to do what you are not capable of doing. You Amen. Say, am I the one that did this?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how to do it. I don't know how I did it though. That's when God works with a man.
Amen.
When you see God with a man with God, be afraid. Because he can sleep in the night, he wake up with miracle. You say, when did it happen? That's how it happens. Lift up your hand, let us begin to pray. Begin to worship and say, Lord, I give you my heart. I give you myself. I give you my soul. I give you my spirit. Lord, you are all I have. You are everything to me. You are everything to me. You are everything to me. Makata mayado.
Everything.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, King of Kings.
You are my life.
Thank you, Lord of Lords.
You are my strength. You are my power. You are my righteousness. You are my holiness. You are my redeemer. You are my King. Oh, glory to your name. We give you praise. I give you praise, Lord. I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you praise. I give you glory. Mama, mama, ya bedeba.
Thank you, El Shaddai.
Thank you. Roko toto moshika la da da da. Ikakata. Oh, I release your grace today.
Hallelujah.
The grace of God come on you.
Amen.
The favor of God baptize you.
Amen.
Receive your miracle in
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Receive your healing in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Be healed in your body.
Amen.
Be healed in your soul. Be healed in your spirit.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Oh,
glory.
Amen.
We worship you.
Amen.
We worship you. We bless you. We glorify you.
Amen.
The saint of days.
Hallelujah.
Lord, clean every tears here today.
Amen.
Lord, lift every body, break every yoke.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Give your people a better days ahead.
Amen.
I decree, I prophesy a better days ahead.
Amen.
Better days ahead of you.
Amen.
Better days, glorious days, favorable days ahead
Amen.
Of you.
Amen.
Good days ahead of you.
Amen.
Good days ahead of you.
Amen.
The God of all will appear to you.
Amen.
He will appear to you in his power. He
Amen.
Will bless you.
Amen.
He will bless the works of your hand.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
Lord, we give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Be glorified, Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
And everyone say amen.
Amen.
Lord, we give you praise. We give you glory. We give you glory.